Hello, hello everyone, I'm Zwalada. In this video we're gonna take a look at the Volvidon armor set, its skills, what the skills will do, for which weapons these skills are useful, what materials you will need to craft this set, and where to get these materials. A quick note before we start, this is the high rank set. If you are looking for the low rank set, please check the description below. There you will find a video that talks about the low rank set. I'm planning on making videos of all monster sets in this game, so if that's something you're interested in, please consider subscribing. Also, if this video was useful in any way, I would really appreciate it if you could leave a like or a comment. This way, hopefully more people will see these videos. With all of that being said, let's get started. So here we have a good look at the Volvidon armor set. I'm just gonna rotate it around a little bit so you have a good look at the front and the back. In the meantime, let's take a look what skills you will get with this set. With the set you'll get Paralyze Attack level 3, Bludgeoner level 2, Rapid Morph level 3, Jump Master level 1, and Evasion Extender level 3. So, what do all these skills do? Paralyzed Attack level 3 will make it that your para build up will go 20% faster, plus you get 5 points in Paralyzed Attacks. What this actually means is that you will paralyze a monster faster and more often. This skill only works if you have a weapon equipped that has the Paralyzed Ailment on it. Then we have Bludgeoner level 2, which gives you 10% extra damage when your weapon's sharpness is on the yellow. Then we have Rapid Morph level 3, which is an exclusive skill for the transforming weapons, so the Charge Blade and Switch Axe. What the skill does is it makes your morph attacks 30% faster. So you can see here the difference between having this skill and not having this skill. Another thing that this skill does is it gives you 20% extra damage with these morph attacks. Then we have Jump Master level 1, which prevents you getting knocked out of the air by small attacks from small monsters or attacks from your teammates. This skill won't have any effects from big hits from big monsters. And then the last skill that we have is Evasion Extender level 3, which makes it so that you roll a little bit further or side hop a little bit further. You can see here the difference between having the skill and not having the skill. Let's quickly look at the stats. With the set you will have 13 in fire, minus 12 in water, 3 in thunder, minus 2 in ice, 8 in dragon. You start with 150 defense. And you have 9 small decoration slots and 1 medium-sized decoration slot. So for which weapons is this set useful? I think that this set is really useful for the Switch Axe and the Charge Blade, mainly because of Rapid Morph. It's an exclusive skill for those 2 weapons. Evasion Extender is a nice skill to have for basically all the weapons. Bludgeoner maybe isn't that useful of a skill. At this point in the game you can get weapons with blue sharpness or higher, and that will do a lot more damage in real. Power Attack. Again, it's a little bit of an extra skill. If you have a para weapon, perfect, but at this point in the game, there's a big chance that you'll rather have a weapon with high infinity, high attack, or elemental attacks. And then Jump Master, it's a little bit of an extra. To craft this set, you'll need the following. 4 Volvidon Claws Pluses, 10 Volvi Carapieces, 5 Volvi Rickracks, 4 Omniplegny Sacks, 1 Beast Gem, 2 Staubons, and 2 Monster Broth. Let's quickly go over how to obtain the harder to get materials. To get the claw, you will need to break the claw. To get the carapace and the rickrack, you will need to break the back. To get the beast gem, the best way is to capture the monster. It will give you a 9% chance of getting it. Same goes with the Staubone. The best way to get it is by capturing the monster. This will give you a 16% chance of getting it. Then you will also need 5 Carbolite Ores and 2 Fusum Ores. The best way to get this is to mine at the Sandy Plains in high rank, 2 high quality belts, which you can get by hunting a Kelby in high rank, and then the last thing that we need is 2 eroded husks. This you can get by gathering at bone piles in high rank in the Sandy Plains. Anyway, that's all for this set. Thank you so much for watching and have a good hunt.